Anyway, I wanted to share with you another improvised training device that I have, and I'm going to just get right into it so I can cover everything. Basically, what I've got here is a barbell bar, just like you would use for bench pressing or what have you, and I've chopped it down to a size that would about approximate the length of a sword, like a broadsword. And the reason being, because I wanted a device for swing training, basically. And then I used the collar from the barbell set as sort of like a sword hilt, if you will. And then I wrapped the handle of it in tennis wrap tape, okay? And this particular device weighs 13 pounds. And the idea that basically is, the old boxers used to do a workout where they'd put a tire on the ground and they would take a sledgehammer and they would just repeatedly slam into that tire on the ground, okay? And I was wanting something that could approximate that, for starters. And then the other thing is, with my martial arts background, and I was kind of into some of the sword training, and what I wanted to do is have a device that could also function for training those sorts of movements as well. They typically, if they use a weighted device or a heavy sword, we're talking about 4 or 5 pounds, not 13, so this is kind of overkill. But it's still, I find it to be very useful. What I generally start out with is I'll do just some kind of real easy baseball swings, okay, slow, like so, until I get warmed up, which tonight I'm warmed up because I've already been running the stairs and lifting and everything else. But anyway, so I'll start with the slow ones, and then as you get warmed up, you can start putting some real smack to it, you know, putting some snap in it. Believe me, you don't want to let go of this. This will cause some damage. But anyway, so I'll start with that. Just some two-handed swings back and forth. And I even, see, I'm swinging with my right-hand top. I'll switch to a left-hand top and swing in the opposite direction just to make sure I'm building everything equally. Okay. Then the next thing I'll do is lever it like a sledgehammer. So I'll just hold it out here. Usually, if I have the height, I'll do it arm extended. And then what I'll do is just lever it with just the power of my wrist alone, okay? Trying not to involve my arm. You know, I'm not trying to force it like this with my body. I'm just levering it just purely on wrist and hand strength, okay? And then I'll do that. Hopefully you can see it. And I'll do that on each side, like so. And, you know, just basically to failure. And then switch back and forth and do that, okay? Then the next thing I'll do is, you can actually hold it out to your side, like so, and this is gonna work your deltoid muscles and your shoulders, okay? And you'll get a pretty good burn going after you hold it straight like this for a pretty good period of time. And then, you know, you'll do it on each arm. I mean, 13 pounds is not a tremendous amount of weight or anything, but it's enough that after you've done the swinging, the levering, everything, you can start getting a pretty good burn in your shoulder, okay? So then I'll do that. And you can do things like, you know, front raises, like so, just working the deltoids, you know, in a different way, like that. I've even done some, like, sort of reverse levering, like that, just to alter the hand position, you know. Then I'll typically go from the straight baseball swing to the angled swing, like I was showing you with the sledgehammer. And what I generally do is just kind of cross over like this, okay? And I know, believe me, on YouTube I'm taking a risk here because somebody might put a lightsaber in my hand and I understand that. But anyway, this really is a useful exercise because it's going to build up your intercostal muscles here and your ribs, your obliques, your abs, lats, everything. Believe me, your whole body gets a workout when you're doing these swing motions. So that's what I'll do with two hands. And then after you're good at that, you can actually start doing them with one hand, okay? Like so, okay. And then, you know, you can even build up speed over after a while. And this is a funny story I gotta tell you. I'll try to get out quick because I don't have a whole lot of time. But with this particular device, my family was over for a holiday. I think it was Thanksgiving. And, yeah, I know it was, because it was right before my birthday. And my brother-in-law had seen this thing, and he's like, there's no way you can spin that quickly with one hand. I just don't believe it. He's like, I know you're strong and everything, but no way. So I'm like, well, of course. So I take him out in the yard, and my nephew's there, my son's out there, and I start spinning this thing around, okay? I'm actually a lot more cautious now, but I was doing it much quicker, okay? Just really winging it. and switching from hand to hand and everything. Well, anyway, while I'm doing this, I'm not paying the least bit of attention to what I'm doing because I'm showing off and I'm just not being focused, okay? And while I'm doing it, if you notice, when I do this with one hand, every time it comes over like this, the bar end comes up, swiveling through here, okay? Watch again. So it swivels up. Well, anyway, at a full-on speed, I mean really moving, it swung around like that and the handle caught me right up under the chin here. And at the time, there wasn't even wrap on the end of here, it was bare metal. And it hit me hard. I mean, hard enough that there was no pain. It just rang my bell, and you guys know if you've been hit that hard. It just buzzed my head, and I didn't feel anything. It just, you know. And they were standing in front of me, I saw their jaws drop, so I knew it was not good. It looked pretty gruesome, apparently. Anyway, my brother-in-law walks up, and I just, you know, I didn't do anything. I just said, I looked him in the face, and I was like, it's bad, isn't it? And he's like, it's not good. And about then, I looked down towards my shirt, and blood. When I looked down, blood was pouring out of my chin like a faucet. I mean, you can't even imagine that much blood could pour out of you, but it was just pouring out, okay? And so my brother-in-law, in all his redneck wisdom, he goes in the house, can't find the right kind of bandage, so he gets some paper towels and some duct tape, okay? And he rolls it up, and this works. He rolled it up, pushed it into the cut, you know, the paper towel, and he held pressure on it for a while, and then he duct tapes it all around my chin, okay? And it held. And we went to the emergency room. And here's where it gets kind of amusing. I go up, I'm filling out my paperwork, giving her the insurance cards, all that kind of stuff. And she's like, so how did this occur? Because they always want to know if you got assaulted or mugged or, you know, or something, fight, you know. And I was like, no, I did it to myself, and I had this training device. And I was trying to be as vague as possible, so that not to get into sword training and all that. And so my brother-in-law, right when I'm explaining it, over my shoulder, he comes walking into the room. He goes, yeah, he was doing some kind of Star Wars stuff with, you know, a sword, and yeah, cut himself. It was pretty fun, you know. And I was like, what? I couldn't believe he just said that in front of people. It was like, yeah, she was kind of giggling, you know, like, whatever, you loser. So anyway, about then the nurse comes, takes me in, and it takes some time for them to set up the ER, I guess, you know, and they're getting ready to stitch me up, and then the doctor comes in, and I'm laying on the table, and he starts stitching me up, and again, he's like, in front of like, there's two, three nurses and the doctor, and he's like, so, I didn't quite hear, how exactly this happened again, and I could tell by the way he said it, that he had already heard this little story whispered to him from a nurse. So I'm like, oh God, I just try to be kind of vague about how it occurred. But anyway, my brother-in-law, it was funny. I gotta admit, it was funny. But it made that trip a little more amusing than it needed to be. But anyway, it did split me square to the bone. But they did a good job of stitching it up. But that is how I ended up with this little tuft of hair down here, because when it was healing, I couldn't shave there. So I let it go. And then, I don't know, it's hung on. But actually, the scar is almost gone. Yeah, it's looking pretty good. Anyway, I'm going to check my time. If I have time, I want to show you a couple of things real quick, and then we'll move on. But I'm sure I'm running out of time. We're at 8:40, so that's not too bad. Another one you can do, and this is the same kind of device. What I did this time, I took a shorter dumbbell bar, you know, like old-style dumbbells that you put together yourself. And I took that bar, then you have a collar, and then you have just a plate, and then another collar. In this case, it's a 10-pound plate. And then with these collars and everything, it's about 12 pounds plus. So it's probably like 17 pounds, this whole thing right here right now. But the main thing about this is the weight's way out there at the end like a sledgehammer. So when you go like this and lever it, you got to be fairly strong to do that, okay? And as you get stronger, obviously you can put bigger plates or more plates on there and alter that. And I've seen a lot of guys use this because it's really a good way to build that forearm and wrist strength. So that's something you can throw together for next to nothing that really builds your forearms up. And you can do various types of levering with it to do that. And real quick, I gotta show you this. It's gonna be coming up in another video. I'm gonna swing the camera down and you can take a look. I'm not going to really do much with it today, but I'm running out of time. But you can see that's two cement blocks with a pipe between them. This pipe is 2 3/8 inches in diameter. And the reason that's important is you have to have a lot of grip strength to grab something like that and lift it, okay? And this particular, with just these on there, weighs 108 pounds, okay? And so what I do is I squeeze it like so, just grip it and then lift it up. Okay, I got a little off balance there. But, and then what I do is I've got some weights. Let me turn this back up and I'm gonna finish this up. I've got some weights that I've got ropes tied through. God, I hope you can see me. I've got some weights I've got ropes tied through. And basically what I'll do is I'll hang additional weights on that. And then I'll keep grabbing that bar and lifting those, doing deadlifts with it. And my personal record on a 2 3/8 inch diameter bar, one-handed, I've lifted 245 pounds, okay? Which I understand is pretty decent, I don't know. It's basically trying to approximate this Thomas Inch dumbbell or the Millennium dumbbell, if you want to lift those up. Anyway, I'll do a whole new video on that in the future. And I'm going to cut this so because we're running out of time. So.